And Wales have come here fully loaded for the Exeter tournament. Georgia have already defeated Wales this season in the opening Grand Prix series in Moscow. Well, there we are. Wales led by number one Luke Trehan, and he's such an influential player in this Welsh side. Two youngsters in number eight Devine and Shea Smith. They've shown up well throughout the season and get the reward from Richard Pugh. Georgia, well, youngster Moribadze, an under-20s representative. And on the other end of the spectrum, Sam Karadza, the captain, the oldest man in the squad at 33 years of age. There is Luke Trehan, a newly qualified doctor, ironically from the University of Exeter here. Took a year out last year to concentrate on Olympic qualification. He made the extended squad but didn't feature in any game in Rio. Zorab Zenzeladze from the Aya club in Kutaisi. Another Georgian under-20s representative. And Wales looking to finish the season on a high here, Rob Bickerman.
Very much so. They have come into this tournament with absolute power, pace and experience. This is, could be some challenge for the Georgian team. I'm very excited to see how the Welsh are going to go here.
Yeah, Welsh notable slow starters. I could hear Richie Pugh over in the practice area over there telling his charges to concentrate, concentrate. You need to concentrate. And let's see whether they've heeded the commands of their coach. It'll be Georgia to get the game underway. That's Lasha Kamaladze, one of the more experienced players in this Georgian side, 56 tests to his name. Lloyd Lewis, an exciting youngster.
Second roll
in the Welsh ranks. From the Newport Gwent Dragons, penalised. Georgia, they've finished all three previous tournaments in eighth position. Got through to the quarterfinals on each and every occasion, and looking to step up here and finish the series with a flourish. Wrestled to the ground, and this is Ravazi Jinshi Hadze to Khmaladze. Kharazishvili goes in, but Wales have turned it over and have it through Ethan Davis. They look to get the ball into the hands of the speedster Lloyd Lewis on the near side here. This is Jenkins. With the initial breakthrough.
Rock.
Thomas rock. Waits and gets the call from Richard Horton.
Throwing the ball away.
Get it back. 2 minutes at the bin.
Hamaladze there, that is an error. Massive error from an experienced player. Absolute no area for that in the game of sevens. If you play the ball or move the ball any time near a breakdown after a penalty is given, you will spend 2 minutes in the sin bin.
Yeah.
So on the ball then, that's sometime Wales captain Adam Thomas into tournament captain here, Luke Trehan. Owen Jenkins again, the straight running of Jenkins finding Ethan Davis, but
knock on.
This is not going to hand.
Knock on from red.
Interesting you mentioned about Richie Hugh there, when before the game, really get into the players. They didn't think they were warming up well, and you can see moments of that in the game so far. Not quite combining as well as we should. This player on shot here, really experienced player. Jenkins has been impressed throughout the whole World 7 series. You want players like that in tournaments such as this to really grab it and control it. As well as Trehan, they are pivotal players.
It's Kai Devine with the headgear. Very tall, lanky, number 8 forward in the 15s. Getting his reward for endeavour throughout the season. So Georgia, one man down, Kharazishvili. Up into the Welsh half, and they will get the penalty this time. Wales not back 10 metres. Sorry, brother, in midfield.
Yeah.
Lapses of concentration.
We clearly see the Georgians getting these penalties, looking for their set piece. Kicking for touch, a rarity in the game of sevens, but they obviously back their line out. It gives an opportunity for their playmakers and big men in the middle to try and get amongst it. Jinki Hadze is a big man at centre. Yep. Expect to see him trying to crash through this Welsh defence.
That is a good win for Georgia, and here they come. Oh, stealing the ball there, right under the noses of the Welshers. What a bad set. This exciting young fullback sometimes wing three quarter for the Georgian under 20 side we saw in Tbilisi last month, and that's a good reward for the youngster.
And what an impressive performance it was from all the Georgians out there. But good to see that one man less, what it means is you can still compete the line out with equal numbers, albeit slightly fortuitous in how he ended up with the ball. You've got to be attentive. Back of the line out. He was the one lifting. He managed to spin around, see the ball bounce, and like a golden egg gleaming, picks it up and puts it down.
Conversion is good, and suddenly Georgia back to a full complement of seven. Wales failing to score, failing to take the advantage of the extra man.
Good skill. Almost like a clean and press there. Throws up the jumper, spins around whilst he's landing, and poaches a good try.
It's a lovely high hanging kick. So crucial in sevens that you are able to claim the restart.
Over here. Pulling him back.
And many coaches try and cite, if you can get one hand to it, you can get two to it. You can see the indiscretion there. A little bit messy. Jenkins in the way. Tried to get pulled out the way, and as a result, it's been penalised.
Into the hands of Ethan Davis. Trehan steadies the ship back onto the short side. Just about gathering the ball, there was Adam Thomas.
Release!
Who helped out at the previous Sevens tournament, helped out Richie Pugh in the coaching lineup. Now then, the breakthrough from Chase Smith. From the Newport Rugby Club.
No hands, run!
Incidentally, Newport twinned with Kutaisi in Tbilisi. Lewis, with a little room on the narrow side, cuts back inside. Thought he might have the pace there. Thought he might have backed himself. Davis into Shea Smith. Trehan. Georgia up very quickly, hence the little dink through. The bounce is kind for Thomas.
No hands, run!
Through the first tackle, Trehan hauled in. That's a penalty against Georgia, and another yellow card.
Cynical.
Cynical plays as Richard Horton, a former Sevens exponent and former England favourite, now taking up the whistle. Wales surely will take advantage this time. Davis checks onto Devine. Oh, breaks through the tackle. Can he go all the way? Should have gone to ground there.
With arms as long as his, I'm not quite sure why he didn't just reach to put it down. Speculative offload.
From red. Gold scrum.
So the chance goes begging for Wales. They still trail by seven.
You see, he does all the right things, gets on the outside, uses his big lever to get the handoff. All he's got to do is ride that challenge and put it down for me. It's just simple skills there. He's already over the line effectively.
Crouch!
So there he is, Kai Devine on the near side here. His first outing was in Lodz in Poland in the second round. Showing good strength here against his Georgian opponent. A relieving kick into the breeze and finds good touch.
Well, that was a phenomenal clearance. If Garen Steenson is here from his Exeter Chief persona, that was incredible clearance. Going from the in goal to kick a ball 50 metres. Is some effort. Look at the angle of this. What a clearance kick. Trying to buy time to get that yellow clock down a little bit for his team. Give an opportunity for Wales, but they're now in their own half.
So the clock ticks down to the last 30 seconds. Another mistake from Wales.
Not five.
Again, look as if they could be scoreless in the second sin bin period. They really need to up the game in the second half as we approach the break then. Georgia have it through Charazishvili up to the Wales 10-metre line. That's experienced Khmeladze.
Knock on.
Knock on, just as the hooter goes. A disappointing first half then for the very experienced Wales Sem squad, and Adam Thomas barking the orders here. Yeah, what was on your mind, he says to Kai Devine. Never mind, forget that now, and let's regroup for the second half. It's Wales 0, Georgia 7 at the break.
Have a breather.
Okay, that's 10 done, right? A bit worked up, probably because we're getting frustrated with ourselves. Okay? Now we've got to scrap that. Three of the first plays, which we had in our control, we just ran up into that 15-meter line, took contact, brought them into the game, turned it into that dogfight that we discussed.
Remember how we
down to six twice, we've given the ball straight back to them. Yeah? We have to be aware of those situations, guys, yeah? We've got the personnel on there that we to take advantage of that. So it's a clarity of mind, but with that comes urgency. Alright? Comes urgency. I'm not seeing it. We take an age to set the line out up when they're down to six men. That's your personal ambition, boy. Okay? It doesn't just happen. Get that sorted, and we'll see this game through. Alright? But you're in control of it. Pictures we've spoken about, they're there to take advantage of.
That's it. Hey, this next 2 minutes is key. We need the first score, you boys. Next 2 minutes. Let's get this ball back off kick off. Taylor, 3-2-3.
Hey! Boys, here, come.
So Wales have it all to do in the second half, and at the break there we heard Gareth Williams, the head coach of the Wales Sevens, giving his players the roasting that perhaps they deserved at half-time, Rob Bickerman.
Well, it's pretty severe words, wasn't it, talking about urgency and personal ambition, but he absolutely cited the statistic that has killed this Wales team thus far, giving the ball away 7 times. That is inexcusable for an experienced and very good team.
The Wales trail by 7 points to 0, get to a restart through Ethan Davis, second top point scorer on the World Seven Circuit this year, and that's despite the fact that Wales finished the season down in 10th place. Behind that, Perry Baker was the top point scorer, the stick man from the US of A, the pace man. Wales need to use their pace in this second half. Owen Jenkins, wing three-quarters, sometimes hooker in sevens. Treha, Davis to Jenkins. Takes the tackle. Commits the Georgian defence. On the open side again, Davis spots a gap. Lewis, let's see what he can do this time. That's the pace of Lloyd Lewis. Rounds his man, Garazdisfili, and Wales are back on track.
That's exactly what we wanted to see in the first half. And look at him rounding up the troops. That's what you want to see. As a coach, you challenge players at half-time, trying to make sure they come out with a reaction. And Gareth Williams very much just got one there. Start off with Jenkins, great hit on the left-hand side, got the ball back. You're a gas man, you got pace, that is all you want. Opportunity, he gets it. And what I like about it, he runs all the way back to the halfway line.
Davis adds the conversion, and it's all tied up then at 7 points all.
Davis asking the questions, and there's a lovely answer. Round the outside, scores it, and back in the game. He wants to go again.
Just the start Gareth Williams and Richie Pugh would have wanted to the second half. That's his reward, being substituted.
That might be why he ran back.
Good chasing. It's taken over by Georgia. Now the extra man here. Wales being tested in defence. Good work by Adam Thomas. Davison very quickly on Maladze.
A cut from goal.
Forcing the error from the Georgian player.
Two massive plays in this first half. Firstly, Owen Jenkins, and secondly, from this man, Adam Thomas, been there or thereabouts for many, many years in this Welsh team. He is pivotal with his defensive plays.
Yeah, he won't thank me for telling you that he's the oldest man in this Wales squad, but very experienced. Stick in midfield, and Georgia have claimed the loose ball through Zenladze. May have won it back here. Albeit a little untidily. They'll get the penalty this time. Alan Bagshaw is on for Wales, wearing number 11.
Gareth Williams talking about the arm wrestle you do not want to get into against this Georgian team, and that's what's happening to this Welsh team. They've got incredible players on the bench. They've got to keep the tempo high. Keep the ball moving.
Davis. Change of direction, finds Bagshaw, the man from North Wales, the sole North Walian representative in this Wales Sevens squad. Quickly again into the hands of Thomas, taking the direct route, taking the hit as well. Using good strength, Bagshaw, fullback in 15s, finds Jenkins. Knows how to be careful here. Now then, it's Trehan. He's got Devine on his outside. It's tall, lanky. Number 8 forward, born and bred in Singapore. Georgia at the very quickly. Bagshaw, neat little kick. Lovely kick meant for Luke Morgan, the speedster, the flyer, and Wales' top try scorer, and he adds another one. Great score from Wales, and lovely little kick through from Avon Bagshaw. I've seen him do that time and again in 15s, but he proves he can do it in 7s as well. Good try for Wales, good try for Luke Morgan.
Bagshaw laying the foundations, lovely chip kick in behind, lots of space to exploit. Now this man in shot is one of the most resilient people in world rugby. On this ground 12 months ago, lost his opportunity to play the Olympic Games, and he's come back absolutely in sensational form on the World 7 Series this year to show everyone that he's still got it.
Luke Morgan banishing the ghosts of Sandy Park, as Rob Vickerman rightly points out. And it's a second conversion for Ethan Davis, and Wales lead Georgia by 14 points to 7. There's Davis, dangerous attacker, and he just rattles up the points for Wales in the Welsh Premier League, as in the World Series Sevens tournaments. Ben Roach is on for Wales in place of Kai Devine, wearing number 12. Wales kick long this time. Gogolashvili. Man from Lokomotiv Tbilisi. A number of these players play in the Didi 10, the top of Premier League in Georgia.
Vantage
Wales.
First one from Gold.
Pick up
second
the loose pass.
Red scrum.
They'll be acutely aware at this point in the Welsh team that there's still 7 points in this with 1 minute 15 on the clock. You can see the Georgians are going to get one opportunity to really try and settle the score here. The Welsh underperformed undoubtedly, but they've got to finish off this game strongly.
Trick the ball. Crouch!
So a minute remaining then, just the one score separating the teams. Georgia have been down to 6 men for 4 minutes in the first half. Wales not able to capitalise. Davis spots a gap, a half gap perhaps on the narrow side. Into the Georgian 22. They're going to finish with a flourish here. They'll get the penalty again.
Tackle roll.
Seem to be taking the full 30 seconds here that they've got. Ethan Davis taking his time, walking around.
So leaves it for Avon Bagshaw. Davis, his first receiver, Thomas again. That's Elliot Fruin. Ball not going to hand, and Fruin, well, he's a past player of the Sing Sevens series, the Premier Sevens.
Red nine.
However, okay. He has just come up with a coach killer.
Time's off.
Given opportunities, I mentioned, likely one chance of this Georgian team going to get to try and draw this game.
Time back on.
Wolves again bring on another substitute in Joe Jenkins. Not straight.
Option. Come on, line up. Not quite.
So one last opportunity. There is time for the scrum.
Number 15, boys. Yeah. Here they come.
He was a nine onside.
Crouch. Davis stands directly behind the scrum here. Might set. Fancy a chance on the narrow side.
Foot up. There you go.
Again being penalised at the scrum this time, so Davis. Well, that shows a little lack of confidence, and for the mistakes that Wales have committed in this match, they will look to give us a better show in the second game, but for now,